What's up, guys? Jimmy your Cows, welcome back, and it's been a while since I've done a backyard front yard vlog, and I had some stuff I wanted to talk about with you guys, more on a serious note, some stuff I want to go over with you guys, and I'm going to try to do this all under 10 minutes because that's all that's left on this card on this GoPro, but I wanted to kind of get personal with you guys for a couple minutes. In the title, it says it all, what is it you want from me? And I'm not one to usually, especially lately, I've gotten really good. When I first started YouTube, I was really bad about letting the hate and the angry comments and stuff get to me. But I've gotten really good at kind of blocking all that out. But with that being said, there's also times where constructive criticism is good. And I really truly feel like there's a lot of you that feel like you have part ownership in my channel because you guys are the ones that helped me create it, and you guys are the lifeblood of it, and without you there wouldn't be a channel, and a lot of you are very passionate about it, and you give feedback. I'm gonna get stung. With that being said, I've gotten a lot of comments lately about different things, and I want to address them, get your constructive criticism, and kind of tell you where I'm coming from. I'm gonna start out, I'm gonna touch on a couple things that I've noticed, reoccurring comments. And a lot of people don't think I read the comment section, and I read it on every video. I read all my tweets, I read most of the comments that I can get to, and I take it all in. And for the most part, I know when it's just somebody hating, straight comment hate type person, but then I also know when it's somebody that's trying to get a point across. So I'm gonna start out with my top 10s. I've been doing Chaos Top 10 now for 2 or 3 years. It's the biggest series on my channel by far. And I switched over a long time ago to where it was community driven. That was the knit. That is what was a little different from other top 10s. There's top 10s everywhere, but I decided to do it where you guys were the ones that kind of, you were in the driver's seat of the top 10. And I'm not saying I'm the one to create that, but it was more rare than a regular top 10. So that became the niche, and you guys really seemed to enjoy it and really enjoyed it if you made it on there and you got a little exposure, your tweet got seen, and your voice got heard. I've always been big about trying to put a voice for the community, like with the Road to the Best tournament, stuff like that. But top 10s, lately I see a lot of hateful comments like, what's he gonna do next? Top 10 Call of Duty trees. What's he gonna do next? Top 10 Call of Duty signs. And they're being hateful to the point of saying, I've ran out of ideas. I hear that all the time. You've run out of ideas for the top 10s. And that's actually not true at all. My personal ideas, I have a text doc with probably 50 to 75 top 10 ideas that just sit there and wait in case I ever want to use them. Most of the ideas I do are from the community. People, more than one person will request something and I will be like, okay, you know what, let's rock this. Like today I put up the default classes. That wasn't my idea. I never even thought about that, but a lot of people said it'd be cool for us to be able to rank the top 10 default classes in Call of Duty. And I thought, okay, well, enough people want to see it, we'll do it. And then I get a couple comments saying, oh, you've run out of ideas. Actually, no, I haven't. I have tons of ideas, and it's not as much about the idea with the top 10. It's about you guys getting involved with your voice. So just wanted to make that clear. I haven't run out of ideas at all. I actually don't even use a lot of my ideas because I get so many cool ideas from you guys. And I try to think outside the box a little bit. We've done all kinds of top 10s for Call of Duty, but I try to do stuff that you might not just see normally. You know, you don't normally see default classes or the top 10 gun sounds or stuff like that. You see the best guns, the worst guns, the best kill streaks, all that, which we've covered, but at times I try to mix it up a little bit. So I know I'm not gonna make everybody happy, and I know there's a ton of people that support the series and support me and love it. And it's not like I'm at the point where I'm just going to quit the series. I enjoy the series because I love the reactions you guys give on like Twitter and stuff when you see your name up there. I just wanted to kind of say that. I'm not thirsting for ideas when it comes to that at all. Other than that, some other stuff that I wanted to address other than the top 10 was the Road to the Best series. Once again, I started this as a way for you guys to have a voice. I don't think there's anybody that, and I see it all the time, you've run out of ideas, you're just in it for the money, you're in it for the cash grab, you're just putting up a Call of Duty informational video. My channel is Call of Duty. I cover everything Call of Duty, but I don't think anybody has ever done anything like the Road to the Best. It's a bracket style, like a tournament you would see in basketball or baseball, but it's Call of Duty. And we've covered sniper rifles, SMGs, we've covered assault rifles. We've covered, I don't even know what else we've covered. We're doing zombie maps right now. And once again, I did it with the thought of interaction with you guys. You guys completely drive the tournament. You picked the maps that were in there by vote. You picked the matchups when they go up to see which one will go up against the next round by vote. It's completely driven by you guys. I just host it and have fun doing it. So once again, I don't really understand where the you've ran out of ideas and you're not innovative comes from. A lot of the content, you're right, just transparency between me and you, a lot of my Call of Duty content isn't innovative because it can't be. A lot of it is time sensitive. We get to fly out and get you guys early Black Ops 3 multiplayer, or we get to fly out and showcase early Advanced Warfare multiplayer, which a lot of you love. You love the fact that you can get some early access on my channel to that stuff, but that's not innovative. There's other people that do that, and I understand that, but that's part of the coverage that I do, that I've built for this channel around Call of Duty. Innovative stuff is like the community top 10s and the Road to the Best series, and if I do other series like the Worst Weapon, whatever, it's not really innovative, other people do it, but I try to put my spin on them the best I can, and I don't know why it's gotten to me to the point where I needed to kind of talk to you guys, but I guess it's been a while since I've talked to you, so I wanted to just address that stuff. And I don't mind constructive criticism. I can tell if somebody's hating or if somebody likes the channel and they're passionate and they want to get their voice out thinking there's a concern. Concerns, general concerns, I appreciate. They humble me, the fact that you guys at times are concerned about the direction of the channel. That's crazy. That's just, to me, that it makes me feel like you guys take ownership in the channel just like I do, and it just, it's this bond that I feel like we have. So I love it, and I want to address concerns when they're out there, for sure. So those are some of the big ones, and I want to ask you guys, what do you want from me? And I don't mean that in a negative manner. Black Ops 3 is right around the corner. You guys know my routine. I'm gonna do top 10s. I'm going to do community top 10s and top 5s for probably the new Gunsmith, where you guys get to showcase the coolest guns on my channel. If other stuff comes up, like we've done supply. Another thing, advanced supply drops. People say you do it for the money. Let me explain something to you. It's not very cash invest. How would you say? It's not very investable when you go spend a bunch of money on these and then you put up a video. They think, oh, you make tons more back in the video. It doesn't really work that way. I do it because I love opening. I love the chase. And the same with CSGO. I absolutely love opening those cases. No, I'm not very good at the game. I'm just learning. But I am drawn to opening and gambling in the sense of trying to get stuff. That's why I do it. And it entertains you guys as well. So keep that in mind. But what do you want from me in Black Ops 3? Do you want the stuff, the Chaos Top 10s? Do you want the other Top 10s like the Gunsmith and other stuff we come up with? Do you want the No One Likes This Gun series to come back? Let me know. I'm going to be scouring the comment section, guys. And I'm going to take the feedback as I can. I hope you guys have a great day. I think I'm about out of time. And as always, thank you for all the support that you guys always show me. It never goes unnoticed at all. And I just wanted to touch base with you guys, kind of put out my feelings and understand that some of you have concerns. And I'm doing my best to navigate and run this channel for you guys. So keep that in mind. I hope you have a great day.